A firewall can help to protect your system from unwanted access. In the case of the software firewall on your Linux machine, you can control whether or not packets can flow in or out of various network ports and devices. In this video, we will take a look at the Iptables packages, which lets us configure rules for packet filtering. We will work with some of the basic options so you have a foundation to expand your learning with practice and the documentation. Iptables manage access through a series of rules called chains. There's a lot of them, but the ones you're most likely to be looking at are input and output, which are the sets of the rules that govern packets coming into the machine and packets going out of it. Forward is another chain you might use if you are configuring your system as a router, forwarding packets from one place to another. The rules in the chain are interpreted top to bottom, first to last, for every packet that comes through the firewall. If a rule matches a packet, that rule action is taken and evaluation stops. So when you're writing our own rules, we need to think it through and make sure earlier rules don't act on packets we want to be controlled by later rules. If a packet makes it its way all the way through the chain without matching a rule, the chain default policy or default action is taken. Depending on your platform, you may or might not have some rule chains already established. We can take a look at what's already there with iptables -l. There won't be much on Ubuntu, but here on my CentOS I have a few rules already set up. I want to make sure that we both save your configuration and, just as importantly, start from a clean state to test out some rules. We will save the current configuration and then erase all of the rules that exist. So again, you don't want to be doing this on a production system. To save the current rules, I will use the iptables save helper. So I will type iptables -save output to rules -backup. Then I will get rid of or flush all the rules with iptables -f, and we will check out the rules again, iptables -l, nice and clean. To give ourselves something to block, let's start up an instance of netcat running on a port 5454. For that, I will open a new terminal and run ns -l 4545. I will dock that one over here and bring this one to the left. I will switch over to my other machine here and connect, and I will type ns 10.0.2.11, which I know is the IP address of my CentOS machine. I will specify the port 4545 and I will put in some text. And there's it. Let's configure the firewall to block traffic on port 4545 to prevent this program from receiving information. For that, we need to set up a rule. From the command line, we can work with and modify rules in a few different ways. Probably the most common way is to append a rule or stick it on the end of an existing chain. Our table is empty, but it still has chains, so I will append to my empty input rule, which I can see if I scroll up here. Here's input. By typing iptables -a input, then I can add a protocol condition with -p. For protocol TCP, as it is, this rule would match anything coming in that was a TCP packet. I want to be a little more picky though. I will specify a port number with --d port. The D is for destination, and I will put 4545, the port we are interested in blocking. And finally, I will use the G flag, which stands for the jump tagger, to tell iptables where to send this packet or what to do with it. There's a bunch of things you can do, and you can check them all out in the documentation. But for our purposes here, we want to not let the packets get to our netcat program. So there's two options for us, drop and reject. Drop lets the packets into the firewall and then just doesn't deliver them to netcat. It drops them on the floor. The remote side would still be able to connect to port. Or we can use reject, which actively denies the connection. For this rule, I will use reject. And now my rule is active. If I switch back to my other machine and type some information, and then we come back over here, I can see that information didn't get through, and if I disconnect on my other machine and try to reconnect, I'm not allowed to. Let's append another rule, basically the same. So I will just press up and change the jump target to accept instead. So now we have two rules, deny any TCP packets on port 4545 and accept any TCP packets on port 4545. Let's take a look at those in a little bit different way with iptables dash save. Obviously these two are in conflict, but we will take its precedence, the one that comes higher up in the list. So we will still be blocking TCP packets sent to port 4545 and never get a chance to evaluate them further. Okay, for now, let's get rid of these and restore the original configuration. To flush the rules, I will type iptable-f. And then to bring back what was here before, I will type iptable-restore-rules-backup. Let's take a look at those again. There we go, there is it. Of course, much more to explore about firewall administration than I can cover here. So, I encourage you to explore on your own. See you in the next video.